I want to talk a little bit now about the concept of the bubble. Those who have listened to the press conference on Sunday night would have heard where it was indicated that based on a risk assessment of the countries from which persons are seeking to enter Jamaica and the travel routes which they will take, we have evaluated specific criteria which includes similar management and profile results for the epidemic regarding spread, death rate, infection prevention and control measures, contact tracing protocols and other criteria. Such countries would constitute a travel bubble that would be governed by modified protocols that would speed up the re-entry process. So these countries, which will undergo constant review and evaluation, currently include, I did not name the countries at the press conference, but these are the countries we are considering to be in our travel bubble. So if you're coming directly from those countries to Jamaica and not going through another country that is not in our bubble, then we could modify the re-entry to just let you move through quickly. So for example, if you're coming from Antigua and Barbuda, where their cases are low. Barbados, similar management and similar kind of public health strategy. The Cayman Islands, Grenada, St. Lucia, St. Kitts and Nevis, St. Vincent and the Grenadines, Trinidad and Tobago, Montserrat, Turks and Caicos. Those are the countries we have assessed now. This will facilitate approximately 1,000 Jamaicans within the Caribbean region who have registered on JAM COVID-19 and are seeking re-entry. These persons would be subject to the same health risk screening. As I said, the screening is right across for everyone, right? The screening will determine testing requirements or quarantine requirements. If the risk screening confirms a low risk status, then they will be released to their homes under the stay-at-home orders.